and welcome to Changes in the Air. I'm your host, Nicole Smith. Thank you so much for taking the time to, tune in and sit down for, these few minutes with me every single night so that we can bring you some change, we can bring you some hope, we can bring you some love. And, you know, if you need a little faith, we got that for you too. So tonight I have a wonderful, wonderful woman. This woman does so much with her heart and her life. And now I want to share her with you. This is my angel, my friend, Miss Vlada. Say your last name for me.
Vladik.
Vlada Vladik. Right? Did I get it right?
Yes.
I call her Angel V. She's the creator and the host of the show Cooking and Kids. You can also go on to YouTube and you can see the videos that she's doing with Cooking and Kids. I've watched them actually like maybe a year and a half ago, and then I watched more because you have so much more this time. So I want to start out with, first of all, tell us about yourself, Vlada.
About myself, you've really put me on the spot here. most ordinary, I would say absolutely. I'm just an ordinary girl, like many girls out there. Foreigner. I'm an immigrant. I'm new to the United States, or maybe not so, because it's been almost 25 years. I don't know how I would describe myself. I'm just a mom of two children, a widow. My husband passed 3 years ago, and
Well, I like how you say just. All of these things, she says just. Now, I had a guest before, we never say just, because when you serve God the way that I know you do, he's not a just. Well, he's just. No, he is an abundant, and this is the heart that you have. You have that God's heart of abundance. So you are an incredible mother, widow, businesswoman, mogul, and giver extraordinaire. And I think with Cooking and Kids, you've actually decided to expand to the world.
Well, I feel that we all have obligation to expand. I think that God has brought us to life to expand, and expand in a good way, hopefully. And this is something that I'm trying to do, and this is my way of honoring Christ. And so I think we all have that power within us, and what I'm trying to do is to, I'd love to encourage everybody else to find that giving place in their lives, in their hearts, despite of what they have and how much they have.
And that is a key, I think, because you know what? So many people right now are hopeless. They are in despair, thinking they don't have enough, or they don't have what they want or what they need or what they think they need. And with Cooking and Kids, I think you are, well, I'll say you showed me in watching the video. You showed me there is so much more that I can do to make life for myself, my child, my family better. If Absolutely. I can just make a few adjustments, first of all, in my mind and in my heart, and then it'll move into my hands. Because I'm going to be honest, I can't cook. and I don't like to cook, because I just don't think I'm good at it. But everybody says that when you cook, it comes from your heart, and it's love, and it's giving. And I thought when I had my son that would change. Well, it's not changing. When I go in the kitchen, it's like, oh, God.
But we all give in a different ways, and we all have different talents. And so I believe that it's just a matter of using whichever talent you have, which in your case, you have this wonderful talent. You know how to connect with people. You bring good and positive out in a world in a different way. So the message, I think, here is that we all have something that we can give, and that is what I would love to see, that all of us all of us find out within ourselves and realize that it is not for us to keep, it is for us to give. Now, when you just said, you know, a lot of people have lost hope.
That's right.
And I think part of my work is dedicated to encourage others. As I said, I came to this country about 25 years ago. I had $2 in my pocket and a bunch of dreams. It's a typical story
wow.
that you hear over and over. And yet, it's been misused so much that people don't really understand the impact of a life that arrives to a new country and starts with nothing and achieves something. And now here I'm in a position where, you know, I've been through places in life when I had very little and when I had a lot. And I can just say thank you, God, that you have walked me through all these steps and that you kept me on that path, because what I have realized in this life is that once you fulfill your earthly needs, you should allow yourself to grow spiritually and emotionally to place a realization that you really don't need much. And that, it was the most rewarding thing in my life. It's reaching the point where, okay, I don't need much. And what I do need, I need stability, security, and I need a base from which I can do something good for others. Now, a lot of us have that base. However, a lot of us don't realize that we have it.
Oh, I'm over here shaking.
No,
because that is such the truth. It's such the, and I have to agree. I didn't learn that lesson myself. Coming from, you know, growing up, struggling with my parents and my husband and his parents. We all struggled. Then we got married. We struggled, and then we made it to having, you know, financial ease, I like to say, and then going to what appeared to be lack,
mm-hmm.
and learning that even in what appears to be lack, I still have what I need.
Yeah, most of us, we do. But there's always something that we have that we can give onto others. So I use my work as an example. I would like to show and share my story with America and trigger the healing of America through good deeds, through faith, through believing, through passion, compassion, and all these wonderful things that I think we're lacking at the moment. I believe that all these things still exist among us. However, people don't have time. We're so busy to recognize it and focus on it. So my story is that I don't have very much, and you know, unlike many people, you know what I'm going through. My husband had passed, and I was left completely devastated financially, not spiritually. And God is slowly rebuilding my life and my children's life. And I want to point out something else to your listeners. Personally have started a movement where from years and years of being a businesswoman, I have now decided that I want to use my business skills to rebuild my community and to rebuild this country.
Yes.
And the only way we can do that is with the trueness in our hearts and with giving and reaching out to others. And that's why Cooking and Kids was born. In America definitely needs to begin the process of healing on many levels. And I don't believe the healing will come from the government.
We're all sitting expecting
things to change from above. We're asking for directions. The government will take charge. Government cannot rebuild what needs to be rebuilt. I think it will be up to ordinary people.
That's right.
To say, okay, I choose better. And I want to do better, and I want to set a better example to my kids. And I want to reach out to other people. And in my case, I want to reach out to other kids and say, honey, you can do this. Let's do this better. Let's set things forward in a better direction. So I hope that my work will encourage others to say, if she can do it, and if she cares, we should care. Because after all, I was not born in this country,
mm-hmm.
but I care enough to see that it remains strong spiritually and economically and in every way, so they can allow many other dreams, like mine was, to flourish, and for many other girls and boys in the world to dream the dream I dreamed before I came here, and come here and realize it, and then pass it on to not just to other people in this country, but pass it on to the world.
Because whether we realize it or not, we are world citizens. And if you're just tuning in, my guest this evening is Vlada.
Vladik.
Vlada Vladik. She is the creator and host of Cooking and Kids.